I don't know about any of this. So they used to work together?
We worked at the same club, El Nuevo Rodeo. Derek worked there at least since 2006, and it's George worked there in 2019. I obtained via FOIA his death certificate. Sorry, that I just ordered, but I got a FOIA of his SSS social security number. So on the death certificate, it says El Nuevo Rodeo security officer. It also has a code that when you look up the code, it's a multi-dose, that's what he's classified on the certificate. They went after people in movement, went after the medical examiner and said that he had caused irreparable damage to the Black community. Why? Because he did his job.
Right.
So I believe that Maurice, the guy that's in the video that was with him in the car, is a snitch. And I'm proving kind of, I'm really fascinated by the anatomy of a false flag and the intersection between fiction and fact. And so there are different theories and I'll be presenting it, but I'm just taking a deep dive, a deep, deep dive into these players, whether it's El Nuevo or Cup Foods or Maurice or George or Derek.
Wow, this is fascinating.
I don't know why he put his knee a little too long there. But if you consider Darnella, who's the 17-year-old at the time who covered this, and that went viral. So technically, any of this footage is evidence. If you even alter one...
It was public, right?
Yeah. Well, her face, they made sure it went viral where someone else, they could have banned it. And
wow.
Technically, I believe the authorities should get that, and any frame is considered tampering with evidence. The fact that you even had the guy at Dragon Walk, which is the Chinese Asian restaurant owned by an African American across the street, that he sold it to the media, and they
he
have
sold what to the media? He sold
the surveillance. Sorry, oh, okay. The surveillance footage, and I would argue, shouldn't the authorities have jurisdiction over that?